Oh, friggin' rates, boys. The old lady's going to get her sticker 2 months late. Why? You're probably going to shoot some pantantlers too. Check this out. We're driving around. 2016 Decknell. How you doing? Look at her. Holy. It's fucking lighting up the van. We still had plenty of life left in these tires here. This one's still mostly kind of good. But this one, that's probably where a lot of the shimmy was coming from. Got to see the canvas coming through in spots there. It's all compa-wampus. Not Dickard. But, any words, frig sack, eh? I got a bunch of shit I gotta do. It's friggin' Friday's. This friggin' Shelly Sheen and Marines is closed. I keep meaning to go there, but then I forget different stuff. I gotta friggin' get this vapal barriers up onto the Whitward and a bunch of different craps. Oh man, this is gonna friggin' suck. So I keep putting it off. I was gonna do it yesterday, but then I just friggin' just up and never even did. Just quit that cane. But anyways, oh my friggin' boom Decknell. It got unstuck. Frig sock. You know that one, right? Friggin' rights. But anyways, boys, figure out what we're doing here. Oh, that was friggin' fun. Oh man, I can't wait to do the ceiling, but I'm gonna wait till the old lady comes home and she can like hold a bit of it up with a stick and different things. But yeah, fuck, I quit that cane. Well, that was a waste of cigarettes. Friggin' Shelly Machines and Marines quit Pug One. They're just busy as fuck, right? And they're just doing favors for Pug One, so they quit that cane for right now. But they got to, he said he can weld up that little threaded arse hole for the rotary table. Got a lot of dicks thinking that it's the mill, but it isn't the mill, it's the rotary table. It's different. Right, that thing up there, it's the rotary table. And then the stovepipe in it with the threaded arse coal, that's the piece that's fucking buggered. This is the mill, different. That is a mill. That is a rotary table, different, right? Not the mill, right? But anyway, so he's just gonna weld that up, he thinks, and fucking recut the threads, stovepipe, be good as new. But be nice to get this back area all donned up there and get the old vegetables producing. Beg my pardon. Hello, Dick from MyFM in Strathroy. Stop by for an interview. Light them up!
See you later!
They didn't say anything while they were here. Light them up! Oh, Dick. Oh, that was funny. Oh, holy. Belligerent. But, friggin' MyFM, Strathroy or something. Big fans, I guess. Scores. But anyways, we got a friggin' get back on this here. Can't remember what I was doing. I was measuring for something. I gotta go drag out sheets of plywood and shit. Did you even notice how classy the friggin' old lady's friggin' rig is? With the new fanty panters onto it. Oh my goodness. So I'll take these ones up to the tire deck at Sarnia there. Friggin' get them to toss some winters on these guys. You know, of course beforehand, but it just friggin' right next to the windshields. Holy fuck, they're dirty. Oh, but underwards, we got a couple packages. Got a couple of the packages. Says, hey, Pug One, hope these parts make this bike mint again. Forever big fan, Greg Parker. If you can, please give me a shout out for your movie to vintagecb750.com and partsandmore.com. 4 tons of vintage bike parts. This is where I worked for 10 years. No big deal. Friggin' cheers, man. Keep choochin'. So friggin' right's got a set of the friggin' stovepipers and a new throttle. Got a new throttle and some friggin' stovepipe Decknells. Sticker Decknell magnets. So friggin' right's, boys. Yeah, we did. We did. Yeah, we did. We did that. But yeah, friggin' right's. A dick ended up. You know, it's like you got fuck on your big dumb goof and then fucking all of a sudden you got tons of shit and fucking just holy shit, right? But yeah, Dick showed up the other dirds and we, and he had one and we just fucking, oh, it works, right? So fucking rights for that, but can't ever have too many extras. So appreciatory velvet right now. I got 3 on order from the eBays, but they're from the land of super cheap shit, so it's gonna be a minute probably, but fucking, you know what I mean? Appreciate it. Stovepipe. Oh, friggin' right, so we'll just set you up here into the cord relation. Try to get this last one opened here. The old lady's just firing some type of a Dinards together for friggin' the sack hole. Get this guy friggin' cracked open here. This is hat and friggin' gloves. I love hat and gloves. Oh, you fucking son of a bitch. Always fucking cocking over my program, boys. Dickie. Hey, close the mouth, downtown Inwood. Beg my pardon. Oh, dick. Pug, I have sent gifts from America. Gloves to wear at the metal dicks, hats to cover your domes, and a Walmart shopping kits. And a Walmart shopping kits. Love the videos. Beg my pardon. Stand for America. Fucking rights. Aw, dick. Dirty old America skull. Got the old Ford cap there. Another Ford cap there. Team Realtree. Another Ford. Oh, dick. Friggin' rights. Mechanics glove. Holy shit. Scores. Safety ones even. Right on, man. Love that kind. Terrible. Why is under attacking me? Oh. And Walmart shopping kits. Alright, I need to deal with this fucking fly for a quick second here. Give me a second. Oh, what? Now what? What's up? Fuck's sakes. But, what do we got here? Oh, disguises. Eh? Disguises. Yeah, he did. Yeah, he friggin' did. Aw, dick. Friggin' rights. That's awesome. Oh, fuck yeah, boys. Skorts. Skorts for America. We did. Oh. Perfect Xeon in the fit department, boys. Love that kind, terrible. Thought it was going to be an OJ situation there for a second, but no. Friggin' rights, boys. Appreciatory valve wide open on that, of cordulation. Scores! Oh my god, I thought that was terrible. Holy fuck, that was fun. Int. Oh, not too bad, I suppose. Frig sack could be worse. But, yeah, we did it. And that was the last of the roll. And look how, oh, come on! Hey, we got like a couple inches short. So we're gonna have to bandage on a chunk there for friggin' my snack. I was just in the shower and the old lady said these dicks came to the door. Want to talk to me. What's going on today? Not too bad. You like the roof, eh?
Yeah. I'm Ashton Faulkner. This is Nathan. And Cody Zavitz is a dickhead. So we're here to offer our assistance. Has he came back to set things straight with you?
No, he ain't coming back.
Zavitz worked with me at one point. The drug use, I can't stand. I wish you would have called me.
Did he come back and make it right with you at least?
No. He's are carrying on Facebook and shit. I don't have time for that.
I couldn't see what he's commenting. He must have blocked me or something like that.
Careful, Slippy. Well, I need a quote to replace, you know, like I got to take this goof to court, right? Like I'm not just going to sit there and let him
I'll help you.
Shit.
I'll help you.
But I need quote for repairing it, and then I need one for replacing it, right?
You need to replace it. Like what he did, put all the screws on the flat there. You're gonna leak everywhere, dude. So to repair it, for one, I would just and I wouldn't be able to do your roof unless we got a new pipe.
Mm-hmm.
Because
well, that's the thing. I asked him right first day he was here. I'm like, you know, the only thing that's on the roof is the stovepipe. So what are we gonna do about that? Oh, don't worry, we'll make it look good. So I figured he had a plan. Like, I mean, I'm not gonna fucking sit there, the fuck, and argue with this guy or fucking make it into something it doesn't need to be. He says, don't worry about it, man. I'll make it look good. Yeah. Okay. Yeah. And then,
that looks like shit.
Saturday, Sunday doesn't show up. Monday shows up. It's supposed to take a day and a half. You know, Thursday, it's like, all right, well, this is fucked. And then he starts asking me, well, what are we gonna do about this? It's like, well, you said the first day you were here a week ago that you were gonna make it look good. And now I'm standing here looking at it. Yeah. Looks like fucking complete shit. I don't understand how you bashed in the rib or what'd you do there? You know what I mean? Like it's all fucked up and just completely dickered, right? So I'm standing here like, and I'm like, holy fuck. And he's like, oh, what, you looked at it? Well, no, man, not really. Look at it. It looks like fucking shit.
So, anyways, he didn't put you.
So then he got mad at me and shit, right? So it's like, well, fuck, man.
Look at the home enclosure. What the fuck did he do?
Yeah. Wants me to pay for that.
For what it's worth, man, I just wanted to see, because I know you do videos and shit. We can help each other both out here. Mm. You know what I mean? I know. People. A lot of people watch your bullshit, right? If we were to,
work something out.
It'd do very well for me. But you're supposed to.
This screw's not even attached into nothing. Like, what are you fucking putting the screws in? Look at this one though. This is a good one. Right there, poked a hole, but didn't actually put the screw in, eh? How you doing?
Every fucking screw that's on the flat part. Potential leak. Mm-hmm. You're gonna have to replace these screws before the metal's bad.
Yeah,
that's why you screw on the rib, right? Because if you screw on the rib and the screws go bad, the rubber washer,
the water's below it anyway.
Yeah, it doesn't matter. You'll never have to leak. Does it make sense?
Oh, absolutely. Yeah. That's why all these are, even the siding. They put it on the ribs for fuck's sake. I never seen it done like that in my life. And when I asked about it, no, that's right. You can't put it like this, but we put it like that because you can't do whatever, dude. Fuck, you know what I mean? After the first day, I wasn't going to pay him fuck all. I mean, just to dragging the sheets up over the intro. No, I didn't pay him nothing. I mean, it was only $1,250. I mean, I would have gave him whatever he said. The roof needs to be done. Whatever it's going to cost me, $2,500, $3,500. I mean, I told him I was going to buy the materials. He's like, I can get materials. He can just, it's $1,000 more. If you want $1,000 more than what you're telling me for the roof, just say, okay, well, the materials are $2,500 and I want $2,500. Yeah. Don't tell me, I'm going to do it $1,250, but the materials are $3,500. You know what I mean? Yeah. Like, you're just being a shiesty fucking goof, man. You know what I mean? It's like, just be straight with me. I need the fucking roof done.
Like, that is fucked up, man. Yeah. I would never leave a customer with that. I would fucking tell you, I wouldn't even come here before doing that shit to you. Like, that's fucked. Like, well, even the cap there, we have a hand tool that's $550 that bends that.
Well, that's what he said. He had to wait till the next day to grab or something.
Cheaper ones at Herman's for like $60. Yeah. It's just a pair of vice grips with a duck bill on it. You know what I mean? Yeah. That's all it is.
$60 pair in my truck.
Yeah, but it just, $60 and that would have been done properly. But you're not even supposed to screw it. Like, he's got screws going in there. You don't have to screw it, and you screw it on top.
Did you see the ridge cap screw in the end of the overhung sheets? Got a screw just through it, like a fucking inch hanging through the... Like, what
Why
in the
you
flying
use the soffit
fuck?
Screw, eh?
The first few videos, everybody's like, you have a problem with all these fucking dicks, and drywall dicks, this dick, that dick, and fucking blah, blah, blah. It's like, yeah, because fucking... These fucking goofs go around saying they can do shit, and then they do it to little old ladies and stuff who don't know any better, and fucking they get away with it and get away with it, get away with it. Careful! She's slippy.
I smell some grass.
You bestin'. Oh, it's like $2,500. But he had me get these rolls of shit that were $300 that he'd never even used.
The synthetic paper then? Yeah.
43.
What kind of paper was it? I might buy it off you.
It's like titanium this and that or some fucking thing. UDL 25. Right on. Well, if you could write something down, like a quote that I can take to fucking court and say, look, I got a quote from this guy. Names. Well, yeah, fuck, like just the slander and shit on Facebook and stuff. Like, I never, all I did was videotape what they did. But he's on there calling me pug diddler and fucking this and that. And he's just a fucking loudmouth goof. He's got guys coming driving by my house yelling shit, fucking, you know, all kinds of stuff. Bad. So it's like, you know.
So, you know what?
Oh, I found it. Oh, I apologize. Yeah, and then like, you know, an email or some bullshit saying fucking, you know, like, that you know, blah, 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 blah. This is wrong, that's wrong, this is wrong, that's wrong. It's totally fucked. It's garbage. It's dicked. Even if we repaired it for $1,250, we still can't guarantee it because it's just cobbling somebody else's bullshit. So to repair it right, it's going to be $9,500, blah, 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 blah. And then fucking...
Well, it is. There's nothing you can do about fixing those holes. You can caulk the holes. Yeah, you still got the same problem. Five years down the road, the caulking's shit.
So I'll find, like, if you do your research, you know, just find out the proper installation for this. It's going to say that it needs to be screwed on the rib. Yeah. Bring that to court, and that right there should win you the overall. And do you have a contract signed from him? Nothing?
Well, it's not signed. It's just a quote paper that's got, you know, a bunch of shit checked off and the price he wanted fucking in the box, right?
Yeah, Zavitz Roofing. He's got Cody Zavitz's name on it.
And phone number, all that shit.
You know how bad that would help me out at this point in time?
Well, yeah, it could have helped him too, you know what I mean? Like, it was completely up to him. Fucking, he decided to be a fucking goof and that's what he got. No. He was gonna put this shit on up and down, right? Like he told these kids, like, you know, pull half a dozen sheets off and then start laying that fucking, you know, this shit. And,
it was just strapping.
Oh, yeah. I'll take it. Is this all about? Are these any good?
All the turnies. You love turnies.
Yeah, they're good.
Yeah, terrible.
Huh?
Terrible good. Oh, he's making cabbage. The coleslaw on it. You best.
If you got that much long power. Does it taste good?
Yeah.
Are you dying?
No, I just did a little bit. It's fucking morning, I don't want to get all fucked up.
225.
Huh? 225. I'll
take a rip off it if you want me to.
Number 5.
Is 5
good?
Are these
any fucking good?
No.
Fucking
better be.
They're disgusting, right?
That's why we put them out there
to sell. Alright, good. Right
on.
I like disgusting shit.
See you later, Fred.
Pull the thumb button, eh?
Oh, holy shit.
Can you do it?
Fuck, you've been sucking on that pen?
I don't smoke.
Dirty turnies.
Oh, bud. They're fucking unbelievable.
Hey, you love that kind?
That is a rock.
You bestin'. These are the guys you want to do your roof. She was asking me about Zavitz when he was here. I said, oh, you don't. Really? Like, they were still half done, and I'm telling her, nah, man, fucking.
Okay.
And
if you want to come and look at it, the guy I had to go back to work in Windsor.
Okay, yeah, we'll look
at it.
Yeah,
we'll swing by.
Yeah. Okay.
The guy, gets all this shit and drops it off and starts the job and then fucking leaves. Like, I gotta quit.
He said he had three jobs on the go.
Oh, fuck. Stupid. Yeah, that's Zavitz. But this, you know, another guy, completely other guy, started her roof, like started it,
and then
fucked off. Like, oh, I got to go to Windsor to work. It's like, like, how long were you planning on taking to do this roof, bud? No. Like, fucking, how about you finish the roof and then go to work in Windsor? You love the tourneys, eh?
Oh,
baked fresh daily.
Yeah, I got my own magnet.
No, you don't have to use mine? Anything of mine you need to use?
No.
You know.
Maybe your harnesses.
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, he took my harness, right? He took pictures of my, you know, him wearing my harness here.
Yeah.
Then he steals my harness, puts it on somebody else's roof, like it's just a picture of the roof, but there's my harness sitting on somebody else's roof.
Really?
Yeah. So I was like, steals my shit and then takes pictures of the stolen shit on somebody else's fucking roof. Just laying on the fucking roof, right?
Was that at Indian and fucking?
Yeah, I think so.
London there.
Yeah.
Yeah, I seen that.
Oh yeah, he just did a roof there. Yeah. He's a fucking.
And he had the harnesses like crisscrossed over the roof, fucking.
Make sure you give us the fucking roof, man.
Right on.
Careful.
You can't even walk on the ground. How the fuck are you going to walk on the roof, bud? But yeah, fucking, I got to get that flashing done. So, you know, maybe we could do... How you doing? How you doing? Oh, really wave to this guy really big time. He really loves it.
Hey, how you doing?
Bro!
Hey!
He loves that kind. He's a big fan.
We're going to probably get the roof from Sandra and Ed right over there. So when I'm out here, I'll do that.
Right on.
All right. And I'm going to go price her right now. So I'll probably get her too. So when I'm out here for either one of these, I'll throw this in.
Right on. Chooch it.
That's friggin' weird. Friggin' them dicks just showed up out of the blue. So, but just goes to show what kind of goof Buddy is, right? But anyways, boys, friggin' big operations going down on Inwood's here today, so I gotta fucking quit. But anyways, big my partner, cheats, here you go, another dick, bug, one, until tomorrow.
Count the lockers, get you.